Ah, good input.
Yes.
Okay, but anyway, Farizal, your question again to
Ernie. Yeah, your profile, your companies. Sure. Basically, your main business is in the showbiz, in the entertainment.
Well, we're in the entertainment, education, and also communication. Those are the three core industries that our businesses are in. And it doesn't matter really what business you're in. Just like Mr. Lingam was on the phone saying that you have to work hard in all businesses. I always have this saying. I always tell this to my people as well. If you think you work hard, work harder. I mean, the day is really, really tiring for you. And when you think you have really worked so hard, you can just tell yourself, we just got to work harder. There is no shortcut. I want to make it very clear and make it very precise. There is no shortcut to riches. If you make money very quickly and very fast, you will also lose it very quickly and very fast.
Yes,
yeah?
Very
if
true.
You work very hard to earn your income, it's going to be very difficult for anyone to come and cheat you and con you of your money. It's usually people who do not know how to make money. Mm-hmm. And that's why they do not know how to sustain that money and the wealth. So it's very important for us to learn the hard way to sustain and maintain wealth in order for us to grow the wealth. Mm-hmm. And that's very key for people to know. And nothing comes easy. Everything requires hard work.
That's right. The formula, hard work.
We have another caller.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Mr. Ernie.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hi. Okay, Saeed from Singapore.
Saeed, is it?
Okay, Mr. Ernie, I'm quite interested with your second advice, actually, to start a business. So, what kind of business exactly that we so-called a new entrepreneur can really venture into without getting conned or cheated with these various business opportunities? Thank you very much.
Sure, I think the very important for us to know is that currently Malaysia has been positioned as a knowledge-based economy. What does it mean? We have come through a lot of different economic waves. Malaysia used to be an agricultural economy, then we positioned ourselves to be an industrial manufacturing-based economy. Today we are positioned as a knowledge-based economy, and what you need to be offering as your business are what we call services. Services does not require you to have a manufacturing plant where you need to be producing stocks, products, and you need to have an inventory of it. That raises the tremendous amount of risk involved. So what you want to do is identify what skill sets, competency that you have, and use that as a service providing to help people. For example, if you have been doing marketing communication for an organization, come out of the organization, use that competency, that network, and use that as a service that you can provide to another organization, or maybe two, or three, or four. Using what you have learned and developed over the years to provide that as a service to anyone else. If you are a TV host for a RTM, for example, start freelancing yourself more, becoming more of an opportunist for all TV stations or even product placements, you being a brand ambassador for organization. If you're a cameraman, start your own production company. I mean, I started as a cable guy. I still remember I did my first ever TV job, holding cables at the football at Stadium Merdeka. That was my first ever broadcasting experience. I was at the age of 16, and that was just a part-time freelance job. So use the competency you have, provide a service, and that's what it's all about. Do not buy stocks. Do not buy things from get-rich-quick schemes and then be convinced that you can sell those products. That's not the way to go. Always look at yourself. Don't take too much risk as far as buying products. Serve people with your time, with your efforts.
So start looking at yourself as a product itself,
sure.
And then start selling yourself, of course, in a good way. Okay, selling yourself in a very good way.
Ernie, I've got to ask you this. Let's open that up a bit.
Sure.
Okay, since our caller was from Singapore,
sure.
Okay, something applicable to everybody, and something can in connection with sustainability.
Sure.
Okay, now. Some people might say, okay, well, although I'm in this line, I'm not really sure if I wanted to venture out into business. I want to be in this anymore. So how do you tie passion as well with starting a business and sustainability?
I think it's very important for us to love what we do. Being passionate about a job is great. Being passionate about a business is fantastic. But being passionate alone is not sufficient anymore today to sustain wealth. We need to be able to devise a service or a product that the market wants from us. It's not just about me liking it, but also ensuring what I like. There is also a consumer market, people who actually pay for my service. There must be a demand. A lot of people fall into the whole entire shock scenery, I call it. I love to be self-indulgence, you know, they just like it's so much that they love themselves so much and they just want to talk about what they have to offer. But sometimes what we have to offer, we also have to start thinking whether there is a market with regards to the audience, the consumer, do they want you to be providing them with that kind of
services? Okay, what about being creative, about creating your own demand and market?
I think it's great to create your own demand, just like Akio Morita from Sony once said, mm-hmm. I don't serve markets, I create markets. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. It's great if you've got deep pockets. I think it's important if you have a lot of money, you can pump a lot of research R&D into creating a market. But for young entrepreneurs, new startups, don't go into a market where you have done so much research because it costs you a lot of money.
Yes, okay.
Go straight to a market where there's an existing market that people want your products. If there is a hypermarket, go in and serve that. You just need to figure out ways to do it better. Cut costs, increase revenue, that's where profits are. Mm-hmm. And ensure you manage your cash flow.
Right. So that's marketing 101 for you, okay, from Ernie. Mm. You've got to identify a need, okay, and see what your resources are, match it together. Okay, that's what he's saying, basically.
So, yeah, basically identify your niche, okay, and identify your market. This is especially for those people with very little money.